Hi everyone, welcome to Basic Funda. In today's video, we will see how we can add a flyout button onto a subgrid. So same thing we can do onto our main form or onto our home subgrid. So I'm trying to create a series on workbench, and I have previously uploaded some videos where we can see how we can download and install Ribbon Workbench, how we can add custom button onto our main form and link those buttons with the JavaScript. And also I have added one video which is the latest feature released by Microsoft and currently in preview mode, which will allow us to edit the commands or the ribbon buttons in the command bar within the Model Ribbon App Designer. So I have also created this blog where you can easily read, and in today's video we will explore on how we are going to add a flyout button. So in my previous video, we have added button onto the form. So in today's video, let's try to add a button onto a subgrid, but this time it will be a flyout button. So let's start. So I have opened the trial instance which I have created. So we are going to add the button over somewhere here onto the subgrid. So let's go to the Ribbon Workbench. So this time we are going to use the subgrid section. Previously we have added this link button and make use of this form section. So this is the toolbox. So from where I can see the menu section and the flyout and the button. So let's drag a flyout button over here. And if you see the property is open, so we can just name the ID. So create new, let's give a name, create new. Now I'm not giving any command as of now, let's create it in few minutes. But second thing, first step is to drag a flyout button, and second step would be to add a menu section. So drag a menu section under this. Without menu section, you cannot add buttons inside a flyout button. So let's give a menu section name. If we will give some title here, so it will be visible. But if you don't want to make it visible, then you cannot give anything over here in the title. So as of now, I'm giving to see how it will look. So this is done. Second step is done. Now third thing is to drag out our buttons. So first button, let's give link, and let's make use of the existing button, that is link, that we have created previously. So for link, I have used this command. So I'm giving this. So I'm using the same command which we have added onto the link button. So the next is again dragging a button, and let's give it issue name. Okay. So now let's create a new command that we can use for issue. So later we can add the actions on this. So I have created this by going under the command section. So this is the command that I have added. Now this is the button that we have created, and onto the link button, we have added this existing command. Onto the issue button, let's add this new command that we have just now created. So it is this. Yes. So this was the existing button. Let's check what we have used in this button. So it is link command. So let's use the same thing. So let's go click on link. So it is link command. And for the issues, I think I have created two issues. So as of now, we can give anything because in both the commands, we don't have anything. So it's fine. So let me go to the button, click on issue, and we have associated the command. So we have dragged out the flyout. Then we have added a menu section, and then we have dragged the buttons. So as of now, I have added two buttons, and I have given the name to the menu section that is create. The button name is create new, and we are using the existing command which we have used on this link. So we have added the button onto the subgrid. So let's publish and see our changes. So it is trying to import the solution, and then it will publish to so that we can see our changes. So let's just wait. Also, in my blog, I have added these steps so that you can also follow these steps and see how we can simply add a flyout button. So the same things has been mentioned here, so you can also follow the same. So it is taking some time to publish the solution, but the import has been completed. So our solution is published, and now let's see the changes. So I'll just refresh. Now we have added it onto our case entity, case subgrid. So let's open any of the case. So if you see, our new button has been added onto the subgrids. So as we all know that we have three sections, home, subgrid and form. So whenever we are going to add any buttons onto a subgrid of a particular entity, then it will be visible on all the case subgrid, because here we are using case. So all the buttons will be, this new button which we have added will be visible onto the case subgrids. So if you see, I have two subgrids. So this button is visible on both the subgrids. So this is the create. So this is the menu section name which we have given. So this is how it will look. So mostly, if you have a need of showing the title, then you can add it. Otherwise, you cannot give a title if you don't want to show it here. So this button's added. If I click on link, it is navigating me to the issue entity. As in our previous video, we have seen how we can add a JavaScript action onto the button. So I have used the same command. So if we go here, so link command. So we have created one web resource. So this JavaScript function is navigating me to the issue entity. So that's how we can add a flyout button. And in my previous videos, I have also shown how you can add a solution and how you can install Ribbon Workbench. So you can check out that. I will leave all the links into the description box. So as of now, this is it. But in my next video, we will see how we can enable, how we can make use of the enable rules. So if I go here, so this is the first thing, actions that we have tried. Now if you come down, we here we have enable rules. So example, if I want to hide this button, or if I want to show this button onto a single subgrid, but this should not be visible onto the other subgrids, then we can make use of the enable rules. So in my next video, I'll show you how we can make use of that. But that's it for today. So if you like my video, please hit the like button and subscribe my channel. Thank you.